at least talk to this Jesus of Nazareth.
Joseph of Arimathea, how dare you consider this?
My brother Caiaphas, remember to speak to your heart.
To my heart? I implore you out of respect for our friendship. Be silent.
I stand before my high priest reverently, but I shall not remain silent. This Jesus may have acted and spoken with excessive zeal, but he did so in the cause of God.
Joseph, are you out of your mind?
The people are turning away from us, Caiaphas, and how do we blame them? They no longer believe our words. All of our actions and words have ever done are to promote our own self-interest.
What are you saying?
We prefer seats of honor in the banquets and in the synagogues.
We stand on street corners and pray lengthy prayers merely so people will notice how pious we are.
Nicodemus, you too?
He has long been a secret follower of the Galilean, and now he has given himself away.
Look around. This city is full of people who have left their homes because the drought has burned their soil and laid waste to their vineyards. They cry out, men, women, and children, all around our temple walls. Hunger gnaws at them. What are we to offer them? More pompous words?
You will be covered with shame because of this irreverent outburst.
He knows no shame. Look, madness is glowing out of his eyes.
It can be called madness, yes, but I think it's more. I think it's admiration for the Galilean heretic.
Even in our own midst, we have a follower of the carpenter.
The activities of the heretic must be stopped.
Today, we must decide what is to be done today.
This Jesus is no threat to the laws of Moses or the traditions of our ancestors.
Nicodemus, how can I hope for the prosperity of our people if I allow this heretic to continue his works? Therefore, I command you to remain silent and to never again mention the name of the Galilean.
So, choose between obeying you and obeying God.
Listen to me. Emboldened by his successes, the Galilean heretic will proclaim himself the king of Israel. This frivolous dreamer will cause turmoil in our city. He will transform our law into godless teaching. And where there is no law, the people become wild and disobedient. No, no. We must maintain order. And if we are to silence the Galilean, we must do so immediately.
We must throw him into prison. In one word, neutralize him.
Yes. Yes, and once in prison, away from the eyes of the masses, the gullible people will no longer be snared by the enchantment of his words or have any more miracles to gape at. Then he'll soon be forgotten.
In the darkness of the prison cell, he can proclaim himself King of Israel to the empty walls.
And that should probably subdue his followers and cool their enthusiasm for him, especially when they see that the one who promised them freedom is himself in chains.
Into the deepest dungeon with him. There, let him remain as one, buried alive.
But who among you can guarantee that the guards won't be bribed to help him escape? Or that he won't use his magic tricks to break his chains and open the prison gate? Or that his friends won't start a riot to set him free? Who among you can vouch for him? No one. I see. No one. Then, as high priest I say, it is better that one man should die rather than an entire nation perish.
He must die.
This Jesus must die.
Die? Yes, die. Now go.
Brothers, do not listen to him.
You will listen to me. I am the high priest and the only one in Israel. You will listen to me and not to that babble of Jesus of Nazareth.
I cannot abide this decision. The fury of hell is upon
me. Get out. Go. Go run after your prophet. Go see him one more time before his hour comes.